It's true. Most of the times a full factorial design isn't worth it, and you can come to the same conclusions by performing only a fraction of the experiments with a fractional design. Let me show you. If we have factors like temperature, pressure, concentration, and steering rate to test at different levels, a full factorial design would test every possible combination of these four factors. If we assume two levels for each factor, we get a total of 16 individual experiments that we need to run. But as I already said, that is not necessary. We can get the same information out of only 8 runs by running a carefully selected subset of these 16 experiments. The only issue here is that by reducing the number of experiments, some effects overlap, so you can only understand their combined impact on the response instead of their individual contributions. And this phenomenon is called aliasing. But don't worry, let me show you why you don't need to be afraid of aliasing. This here is an experiment investigating how temperature, pressure, concentration, and steering rate affect the filtration rate of a chemical process. And we'll compare a full factorial design with 16 experiments to a fractional design with just 8 experiments to see what aliasing looks like and why it is not necessarily a problem. And first of all, we're going to look at the average contribution of all the factors individually. And in DOE language, those effects are called main effects. Now, the full factorial design here tells us the true effect. There is no overlapping or aliasing whatsoever. We can see that increasing the temperature from low to high increases the filtration rate by an average of 21 points. Same for the pressure here. If we increase the pressure from low to high, it increases the filtration rate on average by 3.1 points. Concentration by 9.9 points and the steering rate by 14.6 points. We see that the pressure has almost no effect on the filtration rate and temperature seems to have the highest effect on the filtration rate. Now, for the fractional design, this graph looks almost the same. At least the overall trend is the same. Pressure, lowest effect, temperature, highest effect, and those two in between. However, the absolute values by how much the filtration rate is increased, those are slightly different from full factorial to fractional design. Because in this particular case, each main effect for each factor in the fractional design is aliased with a three-way interaction. So what we see here is actually the sum of main effect plus the effect of the three-way interaction and not the individual main effect as with the full factorial design here. Now, lucky us, the effect of these higher order interactions like three-way interaction, four-way interactions, it's usually rather small and they aren't really of any practical relevance. So anything aliased with them is usually not a problem and the effect is rather small. That is also what we see in this example. So aliasing with three-way interactions or higher, not a problem. But it is different with two-way interactions because they are of practical relevance and they describe how the effect of one factor depends on the level of another factor. For example, we have seen that on average, an increase in temperature will lead to an increase in filtration rate. But if we look closely, then we see that this is only true when the steering rate is at its high level and not when it's at its low. That means there is an interaction between steering rate and temperature because the effect of one depends on the level of the other. In contrary, the effect of the temperature is independent of the level of pressure. No matter which pressure we perform the experiment at, the temperature will always have the same effect on the filtration rate. If we look at the two-way interaction plot for the fractional design, we notice kind of a mirroring effect because of aliasing. Because in this particular fractional design, the two-way interactions are aliased with each other. For example, the temperature and pressure interaction is aliased with the concentration RPM interaction. And we only see the sum of both in this plot, and we cannot tell them apart due to how we structured our experiments. Now it happens that this effect here is rather small. That could, of course, be either because both interactions are small, or it could be because both effects are large but in opposite directions. Which one it is? Well, we can't tell for sure. But most of the time, the easiest or most intuitive solution is also the right one. So that would mean both interactions are likely small. And we confirm that in a minute with the full factorial design where we don't have aliasing. But before that, we have the temperature concentration interaction here that is aliased with the pressure RPM interaction. And those are quite large, similar to the temperature RPM interaction and the pressure concentration interaction. They are also large. Here we have again the problem that we do not know how much of the whole bar or the whole effect we should attribute to which interaction. It could be that one is small and one is large. Could also be that both are of approximately the same size, or maybe one is extremely large and the other is normally large but in the opposite direction. And again, we can simply not be entirely sure which one of these is the correct assumption, but we can make an educated guess. Now, the latter possibility seems a little far-fetched. We would have been very unlucky if we had a scenario like this one. So let's cross it out. Then we already know from the main effects that pressure on average has only a very minor effect on the filtration rate, and temperature actually has on average the highest effect on filtration rate. So why should any interaction that contains the pressure as a variable be more significant than an interaction that contains the temperature as a variable? Right, most likely it is not. And again, the most intuitive solution is usually the correct one. So we can also rule out the second option, leaving us with the first, where the temperature concentration and the temperature RPM interactions are the significant ones, while interactions involving pressure are likely to be small and can be neglected. So let's look at the results from the full factorial design to see whether or not our assumptions or guesses were right. And ta-da, yes, we were right. All interactions where the pressure is involved are small, and only the temperature and concentration and the temperature RPM interactions, those are the important ones. And just like that, we've handled aliasing, saving us 50% time in the lab. And if at any time the results are ambiguous and you're unsure about which interaction is the significant one or which is the insignificant one, if you're at any time in this whole process or unsure or the results are ambiguous, then just run the missing fraction and you haven't saved much time, but at least you also haven't wasted any. Now, three things to remember from this video. First, aliasing with three-way interactions or higher is not a problem. Those higher order interactions, they are usually, they don't have any practical relevance because their effects are so small. Second, if you're trying to interpret aliased effects, trust your gut. You're usually right. And third, if you're unsure, then run the missing fraction of your design plan and get the unambiguous result.